Okay, there we go. Got my Saturn roll. Check this out. So I 3D printed this, and the printer actually like layers shift this on both sides somehow. Kind of neat, but it still works. I don't know how it did it, but interesting nonetheless. All right, so soldering gun's good and hot. Should say iron. Stick that on there. And I may actually crank this up. I have this set up very low because I was doing those XT30s the other day. Yeah, let me crank this up a little bit. Starting to take solder, and I don't know if you guys, you probably can't see this, but I'm actually soldering it on the back side off the iron. There you go, that should be plenty. Now, this other one's gonna be a bit more tricky. Let's see how I'm gonna do this. I always like to get a little solder on there, because when the solder pools, it creates that flow, which makes it hotter, transfers the heat better. You see what I mean about that iron though? I mean, I didn't have really any pressure on that at all. It was just the weight of the wire holding on there, and it still soldered that really quick. Here's another one of those little things that I like to keep for soldering. This is just one of those little tiny handheld pen style heat guns. This thing is perfect for heat shrink. Maybe. Just a little bigger. All the wires.
consistent, that whole canvas.
Probably, I mean, it's not meant to be directly penetrated like that. That's what she said.
I did one side where I did that, and the other side I didn't. So I wish I could see through. Especially the one side where the canvas is more sure. I mean, I already patched it, but it's looser, so it hangs a bit lower. The water doesn't run off on it too. So if I just
I do. It's probably downstairs somewhere, but I don't know exactly where it's at. It's meant for like tents and stuff.
Perfect. That's about all I really need.
I don't know if you can see, but see the glue coming out of that? Yeah, that's what I was talking about with the glue and the shrink. It's fun. They can listen to us talk about the other camper. It's fun.
The other camper? Oh, this is some cute little XT connectors.
And those are XT30s.
Actual heat gun out in there if you want it.
I have an actual heat gun. This thing's perfect for this. So just very thick shrink, and it's got a lot of glue in it, so it takes a little longer than regular shrink to
shrink it all up. Yeah. So the XT panels will be here then, or there?
The charging panel's gonna be here.
Okay, and then switches obviously are here.
Yeah.
Nice. So the USB ones that you have are going right here. That bracket you made.
Yep.
Nice. The good news, the water tank holds though.
That's a bonus.
Except for I have to shorten the drainage tube because there's about 12 feet of it in there. It only needs to be about 8 inches. So, I see that. But it's coiled up, and the pressure of the tank can't push the water through that much tube because obviously it's going higher than the water. It'd probably push it all down, but it looks like it was repaired, and they didn't trim the hose at all. They just put the ends on.
So now here's the real debate. Is can I use a slide-on style connector? Alright, I'm back. So I was worried that this extension might be too much, but it seems like it's gonna work, so we're gonna run with it. These are also like a heat shrink style butt connector. Or not, they're a blade connector, I guess. Maybe, I don't know. I don't know what they're actually called. Somebody will correct me, I'm sure.
Yeah, so my dad called me today, obviously, and was talking about how my brother owes him money, and he's probably never going to see it again, so he's going to spend the same amount of money my brother owes on me. And I was like, Dad, I owe you like 10 grand for the student loan he bought out for me that I've been paying you back on. I was like, you don't need to buy me anything.
Nice.
And he's just like, because he wanted to see all the tools I had. So I went out and showed him. He's like, all right, well, I just ordered it. It's something I've been wanting to get you for almost 7 years now. That's how long I've had it saved. It's arriving July 9th. So, okay.
Interesting.
Hopefully it's not big because we have no room for things.
Yeah, guys, I have a problem with tools where I have more tools than I have garage. Yep. So,
I told him.
It's a first world problem.
I already told him. I was like, the reason why all my tools are back here is because I have no room in the garage for them. I am sure we can put it somewhere, but I mean, somewhere where I can actively get to them, no. So, it'll be interesting to see whatever shows up. All right, well, you'll have to need help with that stuff for a bit.
Yeah, man. Have fun. Well, hello.
I bought a snack.
Snacks? Oh boy, my favorite.
Deer tracks and mint chocolate chip. You know, our huge.
So now we just gotta get the refrigerator in here and we can bring that stuff camping too.
Yeah! I'm good with eating ice cream watching a movie in the woods.
I think I've had too many bowls. Lisa's also really slow with this. These things are pretty thick. But, whatever. I don't feel like grabbing my full-size heat gun out. It's usually just overkill. So. I have a bunch more of these to do. I don't want to bore you guys with too many of these, so let's... Alright guys, welcome back. So, got all of this ready. So, these are all just going to plug in on the bottom side. Remember, this is our main power. And again, this is all extremely low amperage, so this wire is totally overkill, so the fact that I'm running 4 off of this is not going to be a problem whatsoever. Gotta pay attention to which circuit I want where. So this is the center light, so I want that the second one on my switch. I have to shrink that up a little bit. Alright, now the shrink is obviously going to be my ways because I couldn't shrink it on the connector because it was pushing against it. Those little legs are just too short for that. So I'm just going to trim some of that shrink back. Oh no. I just think I just did it now, guys. Gotta straighten both legs and straighten that one back out. There we go. Alright. So, let's see. Main lights. This is my first switch. That's the next question. I should have use my multimeter to make sure I'm putting these on the right way. I guess we'll find out the hard way. Center. I should have a door. Yep. So I have the two outside lights. I'm going to split those. So I don't have to have both of them on all the time. And then the back door light. This is that one I crushed. It's gonna be tight. There we go. All right. So yeah, hopefully I did that right. I don't really know which way is which here. We're gonna find out together. Next thing is, are these gonna fit with those labels on there? I'm telling you, I'm gonna be bummed if they don't. Also not sure if they're gonna fit with these on there, which is my main work. Yeah, see, that's why I was gonna solder them. Oh, that sucks, guys. All right, well, unless I can maybe. Spread out in there a little bit more, maybe. I don't know. Just don't like how tight that is. I feel like that's just gonna cause problems. Maybe I could do something like that. And the switch leads up. That's super tight. So I could 3D print a ring, an extension ring for this, so it, you know, sits out of the wall a little bit. But I don't know how I feel about that. I mean, I really like it just to sit flat, and it looks way better. Yes, the only other thing I can do is just take this back apart and cut these ends off and redo it with solder instead, like my initial plan. I was really hoping these were gonna work. But I should have just did it the other way the first time. It's okay. All right, I'm gonna solder all these up and then I will get back at you.